All right, 4:47, a beautiful start to the work week. Well, some overcast skies right now, a little bit gray, but overall was a pleasant day, I think.
Yeah, a little warm out there, but if you like the warm temperatures, then hey, you're golden. Here's meteorologist Devon Lucie with more on what we can expect, some changes coming our way.
There will be. We've got a pretty strong cold front that's going to significantly drop our temps. Just not going to find a whole lot of rain with it, though. We're getting a ton of storm activity that is north and west of us right now. We've got tornado watches, severe thunderstorm watches, but none of that here. Let's go to WDSU First Morning Weather Doppler Radar and show you spinning that we've got maybe a sprinkle, a shower. This popped up off the lake. It's moving south to north. We're going to see it right here in New Hammond. Let's get in and take a closer look as we go in between Hammond and maybe even Madisonville. Lorraine, Lee's Landing, maybe a sprinkle that you got there, and that's about it. Looks to be east of 55 and just around I-12. There could be a couple of sprinkles in and around town. That's probably just seeing the cloud cover that's here. But as we zoom out a little bit farther, we are definitely going to see that there's a lot more storm activity that is to our north and west. And it is one of the early season big storm chases going on into the central and southern plains. You can see here as I zoom out a little farther here, let me kind of write things up for you. We've got tornado watches just been issued for southern Illinois, into Missouri, as you go to Oklahoma, and even over the Red River in to Texas. This is not going to be coming our way. The storm activity, this is, we're staying away from it. It's just going to be a drop in temperatures that we start to realize. Speaking of those temperatures, we're at 83 in Bogalusa. We're at 80 right here officially in New Orleans. Wind off the water, Buras at 74, Galliano at 75. Humidity is up though with the dew point around 70. It's been breezy with those winds at about 10 to 20. They've been gusting 25 to 30 at times today. And those pick up a little bit more tomorrow, even after the front passes going into Wednesday. So there's a look at the severe storms Midwest and Central Plains. Dry line that's there, difference between really humid air and drier air. And it's Tulsa and it's Oklahoma City that's right in the worst of the potential for severe storms. Watch this front come through for us. Not a whole lot, but it will be dropping our temperatures as we go through Wednesday and the rest of the week. Drop that humidity and it's going to be crisp in the morning, mild in the afternoon. Let's start where we are tonight. Cloud cover forecast, still overcast, maybe a little bit of coastal fog shown, maybe to Mississippi. So let's call it patchy fog. 68 tomorrow morning to wake up in the spots that are down on the low end to about 70, 72 on the high end. Maybe we get some sun to break, but look at the rain forecast here. There is hardly anything showing with the guide, maybe a shower, maybe an isolated storm. Storm Prediction Center said, hey, let's just watch the North Shore real close. It's what we call that marginal risk level 1 out of 5, but it's really going to be in Ohio tomorrow where the worst of severe storms are expected to be. I really don't think we're hardly under any risk here. Temperature will be warm though at 85. It's a bit breezy, south winds 15 to 25. Clouds in the Wednesday morning start to break. The wind switch direction from the northwest and could be northwest at about 10 to 20. And that's really going to drop the temps to highs only about 72. This means we're starting off the morning 50s, but getting even chillier as we get to Thursday morning and Thursday afternoon. Plenty of sunshine, but starting off 40s, ending up at 70 in the afternoon. Let's extend the forecast as we go into the weekend from Thursday into Friday. It's nice weather, chilly in the morning hours, mild in the afternoon. A few clouds roll through this weekend, but I think we're rain free. It's not until next week. That's Sunday. This is Monday if you hadn't heard about it. Big solar eclipse, path of totality from Mexico, going through Texas, Arkansas, and then going up towards around the Great Lakes. I got an article on it, WDSU.com. We'd be in 80% coverage, would see quite a bit of that sun being covered, but if that forecast is right, we're not going to see any sun because of the clouds and storms. WDSU First Morning Weather 7-day forecast, maybe a shower tomorrow, windy and warm, but then cooler and drier and sunnier to round out the rest of the week.